If you need to edit a PDF, I highly recommend Canva. I've used Canva to design my thumbnails, video intros, infographics, but I haven't used it to edit my PDFs until now. And I was really blown away how I was able to edit PDFs, all kinds of PDFs, like text documents, design documents, and so on. And you are able to use it for free. You have an online version, desktop version, and it's available for Windows and Mac. So there's a lot of flexibility with Canva. Now, there's some limitation of 15 megabytes of the PDF file size and 15 pages. And there are some limitations what it can convert, but otherwise you'll be able to convert majority of your PDFs. Click on start using your PDF editor. And here you can create an account if you want to. And I've just used my email and it still used the free version. And then I just found my document and you can also drop it in a box and then you can click view or you can go to recent design. And now it's asking, do you want to use the online version or desktop version? I wanted the online version. I just minimized the assets on the left and then I zoomed in to my PDF in the bottom right corner. Now, once you're there, you can see that all the text was converted. One thing I was not happy about is that it would just clump some of my text into these text boxes. So it wasn't each line individually split. So some of these sections, if I wanted to change a bit of the text, not the whole text, I have to just kind of duplicate and remove some of the section I didn't want. And actually the font of the original PDF was available, so that was great. I can just type in as regular text box and then just choose the fonts, and you can see there's multitude of fonts. You can resize it easily, you can make it bold, you can change the color, customize it, you can make it all capital, and you can make a bullet point or numbered list. You also can control the character spacing as well as line spacing if you have many lines. So a lot of these design options that you can do with anything if you're designing in Canva, you can also do to edit your PDFs with. Now you can also resize it by just dragging on one of the corners of your text box. You can easily cut and paste section. What I really love, this option that you can do, option command C to copy and paste styles, and then go over to your other new text and go click option command V to paste the style. You can use file view rulers and guides, and basically you can line up your elements and make it look professional. Now, if you want to highlight text, Canva can be connected to a multitude of different applications. You click on the apps in the left side and you find Draw Beta. Once you have this, you'll be able to use it as a pen or a marker. Click on a marker, then change transparency, select your color, and then you go over your text. So what happened is you always have to, when you select a highlighter, the marker, you have to click later on Done. And what it does actually in Canva, it creates an image and you can duplicate that section again. So now you can use it to create whiteouts the same way, or you can just delete the text if you want to really hide it, because what you're doing is you're pasting white color over it as well as black one to redact it. It's not 100% redacting the text because you can still identify it like underneath, but you have an option to just delete the text if you want. You can also add links by selecting the text, going to link in it, upper right corner, typing the address and enter. You can also remove links that are already in a PDF by selecting the text, going to the link. You can click delete to remove it. One other thing I like that I was able to do is remove this watermark that I had in my existing PDF. With images, there's so many options you can do with Canva. Basically, you can select an image. You can also use the assets that are already in Canva with images, or you can upload your own. Like you can select the image you have and delete it, and you can see a placeholder. And I can just import another image, and once it's there, it's going to be in my asset, it's going to be available until I delete it. I can just place it over the file, or I can just put it in the placeholder. Once you have that, you can rotate it, you can resize it, you can flip the image vertically or horizontally, and you can also change the transparency to make it like a background pattern, let's say image, if you wanted to. And what's really great, you can change the arrangement, the positioning, so you can layer thing in your PDF. And by changing transparency and also by changing and positioning the elements behind or in front of another element. Now you can also do a lot of things with forms. You can pretty much edit anything on your form. And if you want to type in, let's say text, you can just go to text and just type in, and you can resize it by just changing the size of the text box and placing where you want it. Now, if you want to add check boxes or X's, you kind of just have to search for elements, let's say check mark or X, and then just resize it and place it where you want. You can copy it, duplicate. Now, it's not exactly like changing some of the form fields, so it's not 100%, but you can still do a lot of things with your form. Now, if you want to sign, you go to the draw beta, pen, use a pen, then just sign. You have to accept it once it's final, and then you can resize it. You can also use the text option, just adding text and just typing your name, and maybe using like cursive or script font for the text to create a signature this way. You can also import your signature as an image. You can also edit any large text in your PDF. To organize pages, you click on the bottom right and then you can edit blank page, you can reorganize, you can delete very easily. You can also change the color of your backgrounds, and you can also lock elements on your page by clicking the lock in the upper right side. If you're working on one section, you don't move all other elements while you're working there. If you want to add, let's say, watermark, you go to text, you put draft or any other text, you can resize it, then you want to rotate it how you like, and then you can change its opacity so it looks fainted, and then you can also reposition it to the back of other elements, and once you have it, you can copy it to all the other pages and you will place it in the same place you have it in your first page. Once you're done, you can go to file, download, or you can click share on the upper right, and now here you have a lot of options. You can also save it as another PDF standard or PDF print or any other option you chose. You can also flatten your PDF, basically making it one layer. Now, once you're ready, you can select one page or multiple pages and you can click done to download it. Once it's downloaded, you can open it and you can see there's no Canva watermark. So it's really a free editor. I use the free version. It looks perfect. If you go to home, actually all the files that you have been using and editing are there, all the assets you imported as well. Now, for pricing, there's a free version, which is available online and the desktop application. Now, you can purchase annual $120, which would be for all the pro assets and options. However, you know, if this is your first time, what I did is I used the free version and then I used the monthly, which is like $12.99, just to try it first before I committed to something for a whole year. So I highly recommend Canva. I think it's a really great PDF editor. Even though that's not the primary function, it really has the capability of really editing your PDFs smoothly, quickly, and easily. So thanks so much for watching.